X330e, 530e, or X5 xDrive 40e iPerformance. Discover the ultimate expression of what a plug-in hybrid vehicle can be. Visit Pacific BMW for incredible selection and exceptional offers.
Just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to our special edition honoring senior citizens tonight and talking about where we're going to go with our campaign with the seniors. Tonight we have a fabulous show, and as we always do, and I welcome you all back, and I thank you for watching our show, and you see a gentleman on the side of the screen. His name is Nick Aboud. Mr. Producer, can you please show me Nick Aboud's picture? Anyway, Nick is the one I was talking about last week when I was talking about creating a glass company. He is the gentleman that used to buy his glass from El Monte. Then he bought it from Illinois. Then after Illinois, was forced to buy it from China. And you can go back on the screen, Mr. Producer. And if you notice, you see these sauces up here? We were talking about them last week. And I want to dedicate tonight's show to a gentleman who I love very much. We lost him in February. And let me say his name one more time, Nick Aboud. He was a legend in the food industry. I always called his sauces the greatest seafood sauces on the planet. And the reason why I'd like to dedicate this song, very special show to him, is we are going to talk about seniors and a lot of the seniors in his generation, which was my favorite generation. I call them the fabulous World War II seniors. That was really my favorite time of these people. I mean, they had so much heart. And most of them were so patriotic. Now, Nick, going back, was a Reagan, big time Reagan supporter. And he was also a Governor Duke Majan supporter. And a major President Trump supporter. Nick is a conservative. We lost him in February. And that's why I'd like to celebrate his life tonight. I know you're watching up there, Nick. And it's amazing how I met Nick in 1968. I was a little boy, and I went to visit my dad at work, and Nick was walking on his way out, and I saw him, and my dad gave us some of his sauce to take home and try at a fish market that he was working at. Anyway, moving on fast forward, we have a special treat. I would like you to show us Nick and Catherine Aboud's wedding picture, if you would. These folks, if Nick was married 71 and a half years when we lost him. Now, can you imagine? He got married in 1946. I asked him, I says, Nick, you were a few days away from Halloween. Why didn't you get married on Halloween? He says, I didn't want to wear a costume. Guy had a great sense of humor. And as I say, he was a legend in the food industry. He just created very many beautiful cocktail sauce, tartar sauce, and horseradish dressing. And I got to tell you, and then as the years went by, he added to his line. He's the guy I was telling you about that started his company in the garage with $10. Started the company with $10, bought $10 of materials, went with a friend of his who was a chef. They created these fabulous sauces. And it's all pure, fresh, refrigerated. Now, I showed you the wedding picture. Imagine that, 71 years. And this couple has been fabulous, patriotic Americans. Now, Nick, we have a special treat for you tonight. Be it that you are a wonderful uncle to me, and Nick has helped me and a lot of other people in the food industry. And we always look up to him. We'll never forget you. And your legacy will live on. And God bless your family, Nick. Rest in peace. Anyway, here's your special treat, Nick. Put it on, Mr. Producer. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. I got to tell you, see that picture on the screen? That was taken about a year and a half, 2 years ago. Such a happy day. It was Father's Day. And we had such a beautiful celebration. Now, Nick, I'm going to make you a promise, and I'm going to make all the seniors. Catherine, I'm going to make you a promise. I, when elected into Congress, I will be the greatest watchdog for seniors out there, and especially your generation that worked very hard. Imagine opening a business with $10 and then having it since 1952. And now the sons have taken over, and I consider myself their brother, their middle brother. We got Bob, we got Rick, and myself. Actually, in the wrong order. It's Bob, I mean, it's Rick, then Bob, no, then me, then Bob. I consider myself one of their brothers. I call Nick Uncle Nick. Now, I'd like to make a strong recommendation. Any of you that are AARP members out there, I'd like to make a strong recommendation for you to switch. Now, this is not a commercial. The reason why I'm asking you to switch, and you know what AARP is? It is a liberal, kind of like an insurance coach for Medicaid, Medicare, and Social Security, and it's benefits for seniors and stuff. Now, there's a company that I want to highly, highly recommend, and it's called AMAC. And again, this is not a commercial. AMAC is a conservative thing, cheerleading for insurance, for Social Security, and all those things. Fabulous benefits. I'd like to read to you a couple of paragraphs about AMAC. For many years, there was only one senior organization, and that's AARP that I just mentioned, that is run by the Democrat Party. Everybody's Democrat there. Their ideology is more towards liberalism. Now you have a choice. The Association of Mature American Citizens, AMAC, is here to protect your interest and to offer an alternative perspective on how best to solve problems seniors face today. AMAC has stepped forward with a mission to restore America's moral compass, to make America better. But we can't do it alone. We need you. America needs you. Seniors, hear me out there. For a mere startup in 2007, AMAC has evolved into an extraordinary force with considerable traction in our nation's capital. With over a million members, AMAC has positioned itself as an organization that our country's leaders are taking note of. And we're accomplishing this by advancing solutions instead of rhetoric. The conservative, and I say that again, conservative philosophies we share with our members pave the way for everything we do. In fact, we rely on input and participation from our members as prime ingredients in the initiatives that we undertake. The opinions and the views put forth by AMAC on Capitol Hill are based on careful research and analysis, as an evidence by AMAC Social Security Guarantee, legislative proposal now under consideration in Washington, D.C. AMAC is focused squarely on protecting the interests of America's seniors. We offer an alternative perspective on how best to solve problems faced by seniors today. We're on your side. It comes to fighting runaway taxes, excessive government involvement in our day-to-day lives, and erosion of accountability at levels of government. We at AMAC feel it's time for people to speak out for the traditional American values, faith, family, and freedom. We promise to be your advocate and fight the good fight. Anyway, great organization, folks. I got to tell you, all of a sudden, You know, the other organization, they've got competition. The other organization really pushed Obamacare, which they made a fortune on. I'm not against anybody making money. Love everybody to make money. But if we can have less government, save our seniors a ton of money, that's what I'm all about. Love to take your calls. Anybody want to call in, ask any questions? I'd like to see different senior programs out there where companies like AMAC compete and they get out there and they push, again, conservative values. We talked about less government. Less government, and most of what AMAC is advocating is what I stand for on my platforms for our families. I gotta tell you, when you grow, you work all your life. You want to have a safety valve. You want somebody out there fighting for you. When I get in Congress, I'm going to be fighting for our seniors. And again, I love that generation. I love the dead generation Nick and Catherine grew up in. I mean, if you look at it, Catherine is now one of my greatest supporters and 97 years young. And she's still at it. She comes to work every Friday, make sure her boys are doing the right thing. And God bless you out there one more time. Anyway, we'd love to take your calls. And what I'd like to do is also tell you, and again, one more time, this is not a commercial for AMAC. I really, really think you should look into it. It's AMAC.us. Check out their website. They got a lot to offer. They got a lot of travel discounts, a lot of different things going on with their organization. With that being said, we'd like to talk about how we're going to protect the senior citizens with Social Security. As you've heard, Social Security could be running out of money. I will get in there. We need to keep our eyes on that. We need to reorganize Social Security. That is one of the things I'm going to really fight hard for. Remember, that's your money that you've put away for many, many years. And I'm not bad-mouthing AARP. They've done some good things, but their ideology is way to the left, and they support candidates that believe in liberal Democrat Party ideology. So you can compare the two, and that's AMAC is the one with the conservatives, AARP is the one with the liberalism. Now, I'd like to talk about the election. The election is on November the 6th. That means we got 90, 91 days to go. I need your help out there. We need volunteers. We need people. I've been showing you last week our yard signs. I showed you our bumper stickers. I'd love to have our poll signs. Anybody who wants any, please call our patriotic hotline. Our patriotic hotline is 818-853-4652. We've got the 90-day crunch coming up. We need your help. God, I hate asking for this, but we need 100,000 people to put in $30 apiece. If you could do that, we are up against a $4 million pot. And you know what? I shouldn't be embarrassed asking for you to contribute to our campaign, because I'm going to fight like heck for your conservative values. As you know, as you've been hearing for the last 39 episodes, I'm a patriotic constitutional conservative. And by the way, thank you everybody that came out to the Burbank car show. We got a call on line 3. I will pick it up and say hello. Good evening and welcome to the Passionate Patriots Club. Welcome.
Thank you, Johnny. Hello, Johnny. This is Anna Heath.
How are you doing? Welcome back.
Okay. Yes, thank you very much. Johnny, would you please explain regarding one of your policies regarding the homelessness, since we know it's one of the biggest problems that we have in Los Angeles and California. Would you kindly tell us what are your plans, policies, please? I would really appreciate it.
Well, my policy is, like I explained last week, and that's one reason I brought this glass over, and I wanted to show and give an example. I want to create businesses. I want to create businesses for the homeless out there. And,
wonderful.
And, you know, it's up 75%, and I've got like a dozen businesses of mine, but the one that I'm talking about the most is creating a new glass factory. That's just one of 12.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, Mr. Producer, yes. Can they hear me on TV or where are we at?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Wonderful. Because I saw that video going. Anyway, and it's going to serve two purposes here. You got one purpose. I'm going to find a professional, for example, glassmaker. And whether it's a screw factory or a bottle factory or a pen factory or whatever, or bolts, nuts, bolt screws. Let's say glass, since we have this glass displayed here. We'll go out. I'm going to get a committee together of the greatest business minds. They don't necessarily have to be in the glass business, but they have to have a business mind, businessmen. Get a committee together. Well, I'll be their coach. It won't be government owned. We go and we find a glassmaker. We find a glassmaker. We ask him to draw up a business plan for us. We give that glassmaker 10% of this business. He gets 10%. Now, let's say the budget of the business, hypothetically, is $1 million. And that leaves $900,000, which we need to raise. But call it $1 million because he gets the first $100,000. So we sell blocks, like shares, of $50,000 a piece.
Right.
Okay, so, and we're hoping that an investor could return 15 to 20% on their investment. Now, moving over to the other side, when the glassmaker, we want the best equipment. Now, also, one of the stipulations is that he'll have to hire homeless veterans first. Second would be regular homeless people. And third would be everybody else. These people want careers. They want jobs. Now, again, the government will own zero. We will give some tax incentives. Plus, again, we will create business. Now, let's say that hypothetically, this glass factory could employ 30, 40, 50 people. We've just created 30, 40, 50 people that are going to be off the street, and they become taxpayers.
Yes.
Did I answer your question well?
Yes, wonderful. It sounds like a great idea, Johnny. That would be great.
Well, that's just, like I said, many of a dozen. It really bothers me when I see, for example, I see American flags from China, okay? I see T-shirts from China. I mean, a lot of stuff from all over the world, actually. And, you know, I'm not saying let's not buy any imports, let's stop it. But these people need jobs. We need to get them jobs out there.
Yes, absolutely. Very true.
Anyway, well, look.
Yes.
We, jobs, economy. How do you like the 4.1 GDP that was created by our president?
Well, Oh, that was great. Absolutely and great.
Lowest unemployment rate for ethnic people. And I got to tell you, there's a bright future in America. Anyway, I see the red light going.
Thank you very much, Johnny. Thank you so much.
Thank you for calling. And everybody, thank you for being here for this very special show. Mr. Producer, let me ask you a question. Do we have some time to play Catherine's piano again, by chance? Do we have any time on the clock?
Yes.
Play it. I love watching that and hearing it. We'll see you next week, everybody. God bless you. God bless America. Nick, I hope you enjoyed tonight's show. And God bless you and rest in peace, my brother, Uncle Nick. Take care. Bye, everybody. As a candidate, as I said on one of the shows, I went there two or three times. And it was a place where I used to drive my bicycle as a kid. And let me tell you something. I will get these people off the street. I wish we had more time to talk about my plan. But let me just say this, folks. We're going to have a business plan that's going to include the homeless. And especially, I love you, my veterans. Our veterans.